I'm Tom Mison, and I'm at MCM Birmingham. I'm loving it. We started the day with, I got to meet everyone and signed a few things, and I've just done my first lap of the floor. I left my wallet out of my pocket, but I've planned everything that I'm going to spend too much money on a bit later. It was the one promise I made when I came here, was that I wouldn't spend all my money on things, but I've already seen too much that I want. Well, actually, rather than questions, there have been lots of congratulations this time, because a few days ago we just heard that we've been picked up for a season 3. So it's nice to see that there are lots of people pleased with that, rather than people coming up and saying, oh God, a third one. So that's nice to have lots of congratulations. With season 2, I believe we've just had the what is known as the mid-season finale, where John Noble's character, who is Henry, my son, has just stabbed the demon Moloch with the sword of Methuselah, of course. And so now, potentially, the apocalypse is over. And the big question now is, what does Ichabod do now that the apocalypse is over, when his whole purpose has been to thwart it? So Ichabod and Abby will now have to find a new direction. Or will they? Well, Ichabod's kind of settled into the 21st century to an extent. And he's got used to the workings of people around him more than anything. They're now more familiar with their mission as witnesses. They know what they have to do. So there's a real picking up of the pace because of that. But then, of course, now that Moloch could be dead, what do they do with that pace? It's very difficult to answer questions about season 3 because I know what's coming up at the end of season 2, and I don't want any spoilers. I think the show works. The show's at its very best when, effectively, it's a horror show. I would like to see in season 3 it become very scary. There were some episodes in the first season where people would say that they were frightened by it. That it made them jump, or it was really tense for them. That's what I want back. You'll see an episode coming up in a few weeks. I can't remember what the episode was called, but there are these creatures called Reavers who are created by a certain someone in the past to protect a certain building from the past. I'm trying not to give spoilers. The Reavers frightened me because there's lots of them. They've got like fish hooks that hold their eyes open, and their lips have all gone away, and they just run at you. And it surprised me because I didn't know they were going to run at me screaming, trying to attack me. So on the first take, I don't think I'm allowed to say I shat myself, but I shat myself. They're scary. I think that's the scariest. There's loads of them. Plus, you know, the headless horseman, when he's riding at you on a horse with an axe, his horse is massive. And we've got a brilliant guy called Craig, who is the head. We have 3 headless horsemen. We have Craig, who is the headless horseman on a horse. We have Jeremy, who's the headless horseman off a horse. And then we have Neil, of course, who is the headless horseman with a head. And they're all excellent, and they all seem to love attacking me in different ways. We're very lucky with the cast. I've thought it from the beginning. When I signed up to the first season, they'd already cast Nicole, who I was already a fan of, and they'd already cast Katia, who, by weird coincidence, we were in an episode of Lewis together years and years ago. So already I knew that it would be a classy cast and a fun cast. And then the more people who have come to join us, just I think the luckier we've been. And I think that's part of what will allowed the show some longevity, I think, is it's a group of actors who just like playing with each other. If you'll excuse the phrase. Yeah, there are lots of supernatural shows, but the thing that Sleepy Hollow has, I think, is that it doesn't take itself too seriously. There's always levity, and rarely is it at the expense of the show. The joke isn't about the show. The show gets the joke. So the characters can be in very dangerous, threatening situations, and we can play that as very, very real. But the show knows its own absurdity, which is quite uncommon, even out of genre shows. That's just something you don't see very often. And I suspect that's a large part of its success. We do have a lot of fun. As I said, we're very lucky with the cast, but it's hard work. When you've got 12 pages and it's just exposition explaining about the goblet of something or other that Thomas Jefferson found in such and such a date. I'm not very good at remembering dates, and I have loads of dates to remember. So there's pages of exposition, and then you're running through forests at 3 a.m, getting bitten by North Carolinian mosquitoes. You kind of have to have a laugh afterwards, because otherwise you'd go quite insane. I like to think I'm not like Ichabod. Often if I meet people and I complain about something, they go, that's Ichabod. So I try not to dislike things. He's moody, and he's occasionally very selfish, and he's cantankerous, and I hope I'm not any of those things. Yeah, he's also heroic, and he's loyal, and so I'll go with that. Yes, I'm like Ichabod because I'm heroic. Fortunately, it's not one of those shows where they say, you've got the part, now you've got to go to the gym for 6 months. I'm very relieved with that. I'm not a fan of gyms. So no, that's not any preparation. I don't need to bulk up for this, which is fortunate. The second season is slightly different to the first. There was an attempt to develop the characters in a certain way and follow certain stories within the characters that meet a resolution at the end of the second season. Whereas the first was far more action, running around, finding answers. And season two, it feels as though it took a little step back in order to explore things. But that's coming to an end before the end of this season. And it ends on a bang, and season three can pick up on a bigger bang. I loved coming to conventions. They're just the happiest places you can be. People are only here because they like things. No one's coming here because they dislike the people involved or they dislike dressing up in cosplay. It's purely because we enjoy things. And you don't really get many other places like that. And it doesn't matter who you are, how old you are, or what your background is. You can come to a convention and it's just fun. It's just nice. It's friendly. And if I wasn't here working, I'd be here dressed up. To everyone watching Sleepy Hollow, thanks so much. And everyone, I think, will be at various points within the second season. Some have finished it, some are on their way. Thank you, and I'm pleased that there's a third season so we can give you more.